Well, hello everyone, and it's lovely to be with you again for another one of our online assemblies. So let's begin with our greeting. The Lord be with you. Thank you. Now, on the 2nd of February each year, the church celebrates the festival called Candlemas, which remembers when Mary and Joseph took the baby Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem to dedicate him to God, a bit like a christening. Now, I don't know if any of you have ever been to a christening, but it's a bit like one of those. Now, what do you think it was like for a poor young couple from the north seeing the great temple in Jerusalem for the first time? Because you see, this temple was the largest holy place in the whole world. It covered an area of 144,000 square meters. Now, you might not know how big that is, but if you can imagine the size of a football pitch, a full-size football pitch, well, this temple was the size of 29 football pitches. It was absolutely mind-blowing. It was 460 meters to the east, 315 meters to the north, 280 meters to the south, and the western wall was 485 meters long. The walls above ground rose 30 meters. That's like a 10-story block of flats tall. And the foundations went under the ground 20 meters. The smallest stones weighed between 2 and 5 tons. And the largest stone of them all, probably the largest building stone ever in history, was 13.6 metres long, 4.6 metres thick, and 3.3 metres high. And it was estimated that would weigh about 570 tonnes. Absolutely massive. And so from this, we can reckon that it would have been a pretty amazing sight for Mary and Joseph. You know, just imagine the awesomeness of a massive, famous religious building compared to the tiny bundle of the baby in Mary's arms and the poor man's gift of two pigeons that Joseph was carrying. But before we have a closer look at that story, let's have a song. And this song may be new for some of you, but it's really cool. It's called Shackles. It's a song that might be new to some of you, but I think you'll enjoy it, and it's got some great dance moves as well. So see if you can join in.
Sure is hot out here. No, I don't mind though. Just glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
Just won't praise you.
We both are changing.
Did you have a good dance? I hope you did. You might be a bit worn out now, I guess, but I hope you had a good time with that. And now we're going to have our story time, and we're going to watch a video about Jesus being taken to the temple.
Come and see Jesus, the Son. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Jesus is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem in a barn because there was no room in the inn for him. After Jesus was born, his mother, Mary,
Hi.
And her husband, Joseph,
Heyo.
Took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem. There was a man named Simeon who loved God. God has told Simeon that he would meet the Savior before he died. When Mary and Joseph arrived at the temple, Simeon was there.
Oh my!
When Simeon saw Jesus, he took him in his arms and blessed him.
Thank you.
He knew that this was the promised child who would save them all.
It's true.
Mary and Joseph were amazed at his words. There was also a woman named Anna in the temple. When she saw the baby that Simeon was holding and heard all that he had said, she gave thanks to God and told everyone that the Savior had come. When everything had been done as God commanded, Mary and Joseph went home to Nazareth.
Now in that video, one of the people that we met was called Anna. And I now want to look at that story, but from her point of view. Anna was really, really old. She was a great grandma. And while you're listening to her story, I want you to imagine that you're there. You're in that building. You're watching all this happen. I want you to use your imagination, and we'll come back to that at the end. So here we go. Great-grandma Anna was unstoppable. Most great-grannies, when they reach their 80s, are just about ready to put their feet up, to take things a bit easier and let others do the rushing around and the worrying. But not Anna. Nothing seemed too much trouble for Anna. She was unstoppable. She was as busy serving God and his people at 84 years old as she had been when she was 24 years old. The temple in Jerusalem was the centre of her life. And it wasn't just the services where morning and evening, rain or shine, she was always there, right in the front row, singing and praying her heart out. But she was also there for all the routine temple jobs as well. You know, she did the cleaning. She did it so well that no one ever had to use a dusty prayer book. She made the tea. So well that no one ever went away thirsty. She welcomed people at the door. So well that no one ever felt like a stranger. And she was always ready with a smile and a kind word for the lonely or a special prayer for those in trouble. They called her the prophetess, and that was quite an honour in those days. Very few women in history had been given such a special title. Now, great-grandma Anna was unstoppable, but great-grandma Anna had a special secret as well. From time to time, she shared it with those who were ready to listen. You see, when she was praying and singing and welcoming and making the tea and cleaning and caring for others, she was also doing something else. She was on the lookout. She was waiting for God's promised rescuer, the one that God had said would come to sort out the mess of this world. And she was sure that she was going to meet him one day, although time was ticking on for Anna. Well, it was a very ordinary morning when something most extraordinary happened. A young couple arrived with their six-week-old baby for a special thank you service. And Anna, as usual, was unstoppable, handing out the books, smiling to the worshippers, and welcoming new visitors. But when she saw this couple, and in particular this baby boy, she thought that there was something very special about him. But what was it? Well, by the time she went into the service to join with everyone for the celebration, she saw a most amazing thing. The baby was no longer in the arms of his mother, but had been picked up by a friendly elderly man. She knew him because he often visited the temple. Younger than her, but even so, he was a granddad in his own right too. But that wasn't the most remarkable thing. This granddad was singing. A singing granddad. Well, for once, the unstoppable Anna was stopped in her tracks. Grandad Simeon, that was his name, was singing about the baby. These were the words of his song. Now I can go in peace, and my long waiting cease. God's rescuer has come, a light for everyone. Well, Anna just stood and looked, open-mouthed. There had been something special about this baby. This was the one that she'd been waiting for. God's special rescuer. God's special light for the world. A baby. Of course, how like God to take them all by surprise. Well, Anna was so excited that she'd finally met the one she'd been waiting for. The baby Jesus. He was the light of the world. And of course, Anna couldn't contain herself. She told everyone about it. She told the people who came to the temple doors. She told the people who drank her temple tea. She told the people she prayed with on the temple steps. She even told the people with whom she cleaned the temple ornaments. And you see, because of this great grandma, lots of people got to hear about Jesus, the light of the world. Anna was unstoppable, and so, as it turned out, was the light that was Jesus. So, that was what Anna saw that day. Now remember, I asked you to imagine that you were there. And what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to pause this assembly for a few minutes, and I want you to talk about the things that you imagined. You know, what did you see that happened? What did you do? What did you make of it all? And how do you think people responded to what Anna told them about Jesus being the light of the world? So pause it now and have that conversation, and then we'll come back. Well, welcome back, and I hope you had a good conversation then. And I'm now going to say a short prayer, after which we'll say the Lord's Prayer together. So let's pray. Lord Jesus Christ, light of the nations and glory of Israel, make your home among us and present us pure and holy to your heavenly Father as you were presented at the temple. Amen.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Well, I hope you enjoyed learning about Candlemas today. That's when we remember Mary and Joseph taking the baby Jesus to the temple and their meeting Simeon and great-grandma Anna. And I look forward to seeing you again for another assembly next week. Bye!
Woo. Show is hot out here. No? I don't mind though. I'm glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
Pressure fell on me. I thought I was gonna lose my mind.